We've managed to reach the first place I'm gonna dive, so I'm gonna get my gear on, get underwater. We've got a full day out here, and if we get lucky, we'll find some cool stuff.
First decent meg. I'll take that any day. I gotta get these tanks switched out.
That is not a bad first tank. That one right there, that tooth is gorgeous. Super rare colors for this area. Hopefully, after I get this tank changed out over here, we can get on more of these megs, because that is a really good sign. I've got my gear swapped, ready to get back underwater. According to this, though, I'm already 5 feet under, but there probably is something else incredible underneath there. We just gotta go find it.
Holy shit!
Gosh, I'm so nervous I'm gonna drop this. This is my best tooth from this location. That is freaking sick and it's perfect. I'm gonna go take this to the boat. I cannot swim anymore. I'm so afraid I might lose this.
I think it's time to show this thing off. Oh my god, it's nice. This is absolutely, without a doubt, one of the best shark teeth I have ever found. It's over 4 inches, about 4 1/4. Dang, we're about to get some crazy rain too. But that thing is nuts. I still have a ton of air left, actually. Let's take a look at this over here. I think I only used up 500 PSI. Yeah, I still got plenty of time to go back in there and find something else like that. That tooth is so crazy. It's making me freak out a little bit. It's honestly kind of hard to describe how rare a tooth like this is. This is exceptional preservation. This came straight out of the formation, and that's why almost every single serration on this thing is preserved. You never see that. And if I don't find anything else today, I'm going home happy, because that is a trip maker for sure. But we still have plenty of air, so I'm gonna get back underwater. We have been getting really, really lucky today. Most of the fossils we've been finding come from a marine deposit, but there's also an ice age deposit out here. And look at that. That is a nearly fully rooted mastodon tooth. This one's from an older individual. I can tell because it has a lot of wear on this side of the tooth. We also got a massive alligator vertebrae, but that thing, these are so rare and such cool fossils. The American mastodon, the first animal recognized as extinct by science. And that right there, that is a tooth to one. A really incredible reminder of how big and cool these animals were. I still have plenty of air left. It's raining on us, but I'm gonna get back underwater. There's gotta be more stuff in there.
That's crazy.
Okay, so the mastodon teeth have multiplied. We've got two now from the same animal. And look at all of the shark teeth we're still finding. I don't know what's up with today, but it is weird to be this lucky. And I am not gonna take that luck for granted, so I'm gonna get back underwater. And maybe there's more in there. I don't know. Looks like my luck has finally started to peter out, but not before finding an absolutely insane amount of material. We got in a really interesting lens near the end of the last dive, where we found some really high quality white shark teeth. This is the shark that evolved into the great white shark that lived at the same time as Megalodon. We also continued to find material eroding out of the ice age layer. These are a couple of horse teeth. We got a bison tooth, glyptodon armor, giant armadillo armor. We found a beat up mammoth tooth broken up into a bunch of pieces. And then look at that. Two associated mastodon molars, almost fully rooted. And they look very nice next to the biggest teeth that we found. I think a few of these small ones I might need to throw back and let them grow some more. This really was a once in a lifetime hunt. You do not normally find this much material and this kind of quality from the Ice Age, from the Miocene when Megalodon ruled. It's kind of crazy, but it's been a really long day for me. That was some of the worst dive conditions I've had to deal with. I literally could not move without that pick, without that screwdriver, and I still need to bail out my boat before heading home, but it was a really awesome hunt. I really appreciate all of you guys for joining me on the river today. If you enjoyed this video and are new to the channel, subscribe, and I will continue to teach you guys about this incredible history that's just beneath our feet. And as always, keep on digging science.